Don't forget to subscribe.
Okay, hi guys. Today we'll be dealing with arithmetic progressions. When a sequence have a constant difference, it is called an AP. It is called AP, a constant difference. For example, let's have an example to understand vividly what it means by an AP. So if we have 1, 4, 7, we have 10, we have 13, like etc, etc. Now you see that the difference between this place and this place is 3, like 4 minus 1, this is 3, we have 7 minus 4 is 3, 10 minus 7 is 3, 13 minus 10 also is 3. So this difference, we said it's a constant difference, you know, this is 3, 3, that's what we said. And this one used to be t1, this is t2, this is t3, this is t4, and this is t5. Another example we can use is when we have a comma a plus d, okay, a plus 2d, and we have a plus 3d, etc. Also, so you will see that the difference between this one also, like imagine we say t2 minus t1. So when you do this, which is a plus d minus a, so if this one cancel this, we will have what? We will have d. The same way you can have t3 minus t2, which is a plus 2d then minus a plus d. Now a will cancel a, so imagine, and also this is minus, sorry, let me open it back, this is a plus 2d minus a plus d. Now, and this is when you open this, you are going to have a plus 2d minus 10 plus is minus a minus 10 plus also minus d. So when you have this, a will cancel a, then this is 2d minus d, we are going to have what? D. You see that the constant this thing is d, the constant is d. I'm going to be giving us the necessary things we need in AP. The first thing is the first term, the first term of an AP, which is a. So the first term of this sequence is this place. The first term of this sequence is 1, is this 1. So again, we will be dealing with the common difference, So the common difference is d, and the common difference in this place is 3. The common difference in this place is d. And all, and another thing we'll be dealing with is the n term, formula for an n term, which is equal to a plus n minus 1 d. You know, our a is the first term, d is the common difference, and n is the n term. We have sum of AP, which is equal to n all over 2 into bracket 2a plus n minus 1 then d. So it's not that difficult. N divided by 2, you're going to see when we begin to do exercise. So this is an example. Find the sum of the first 20 terms of this series, 8, 12, 16, 92. Though the formula is saying, the question is asking for the sum of the first 20 terms. Now the formula for sum, the other time I wrote, is n divided by 2 into bracket 2a plus n minus 1 d. Now our n, these are the things we need in this place, is 20, n is 20, our a is 8. I said the first term is 8, and our d is equal to t2 minus t1, which is equal to 12 minus 8, which is equal to 4. Very, very simple to deal with. Now just input this into this. We have s20 is equal to 20 divided by 2 into brackets 20 then 8 plus 20 minus 1 then 4. You know, this is our D. So when you do this, you are going to have 10 into brackets. This is 2, actually, sorry. We are going to have 16, then plus 19, 4. Now, you are going to have this as 10 into 16 plus. When you multiply this together, you are going to have 76. So we are having 10 into bracket of this and this. When you add this together, you are going to have 92. So the answer, sum of the 20 term is 920. You can see it's very simple. Okay, this is another example. Determine the 16 terms of this series 2, 7, 12, 7. Now first thing first, the 16 terms. Formula for n time is tn is equal to a plus n minus 1 d, like I wrote the other time. Now you have your a to be 2, your n to be 16, and d will be 7 minus 2, which is equal to what? Which is equal to 5. Now put this into this equation. T16 is equal to 2 plus 16 minus 1, then 5. So when you do this, now you are going to have 2 plus 15 multiplied by 5, and this is T16. So when you do this formula, when you do this equation, you are going to have 77. That's the second question they can ask you. Now this is another question they can ask you. Imagine they did not give you the first term, they did not give you any sequence. So they said the sixth term for an AP is 17 and 13 times 38. Determine the 19 times. Before you can determine the 19 times, you have to have your what? Your A and your D. And these are you're going to have the six terms of an AP is going to be six times is equal to A plus 5 D, and they said is 17. Now the 13 times is going to have a plus 12 d is equal to 38. How did I know this? So if you have a plus 5 d, just remove, this is 6 times, that's going to just remove 5, like just remove 1 from this 6. I'm going to have, because the first time is a, second time is a plus d, third time is a plus 2 d, the fourth a plus 3 d, the fifth a plus 4 d, and the sixth a plus 5 d. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this is simultaneous equation. So this is simultaneous equation in order for you to get it. So this is a simultaneous equation, equation 1, equation 2. From equation 1, this equation 1, you can make a subject of formula, and a is going to be 17 minus 5 d. And this is going to be equation 3. From this place, from this equation, we make this subject of formula. We make a subject of formula. Now put a in equation 2. Now for us to get this thing, well, we have an equation 2 is a plus 12d is equal to 38. So we are having 17 minus 5d plus 12d is equal to 38. Now you can remove this. Minus 5d plus 12d is equal to 38 minus 17. Bring this one to the other side. Now minus 5 12d, you are going to have 7d is equal to 21 when you do this. So our d is going to be what? 3, because 7 21 is 3. So you can get your a now. So put D in equation 3. Equation 3 to get our A. So A is equal to 7 minus 5 D, which is 3. Now we are having A is equal to 7 minus 15. So our A is equal to what? Our A is equal to 2. We have A now, we have D. We can find the 19th terms. Now they asked us to find the 19th terms, and this is equal to a plus n minus 1 then d. We have our a to be 2 plus 19 minus 1 then d is 3. So by this now we are having 2 plus 18, then we have 3. So when you do this, multiply it by 3, that's 54, then 54 plus 2, we are having 56. 6. It's very simple when they ask you to do this kind of equation. You are not giving A, you are not giving D. So, and these are the all questions that can be asked in AP, actually. This is the all question that can be asked. So, thanks for watching our YouTube channel, our videos. Always subscribe to our YouTube channel if you have not subscribed, and click on the notification bell in order to be informed or notified when we post another video. Thank you very much.